Good evening, folks. Today I'm going to tell you the story of a demon who inflates. This is the story of Agasur. This story comes from the books of Mahabharata, from the life of Lord Krishna. There was a prophecy that the eighth son of Devaki, called Krishna will kill the king Kansa, who happens to be his uncle as well. Now, Kansa made various attempts to kill his nephew to defy this prophecy. All those attempts in the form of Putana and Bakasur resulted in the death of these two demons at the hands of Krishna. Frustrated with the outcomes, Kansa turns to his great general Agasur, who happens to be the brother of Bakasur. Agasur was more than pleased to kill Krishna, as he sees it as a revenge of his brother's death. To kill Krishna, he devises a strategy. He takes the form of a giant python, which is 8 miles long, and hides in the jungles where Krishna and his friends come to play. He stays next to a mountain with his mouth wide open, which from a distance looks like the opening of a cave. When Krishna and his friends come to the jungle to play, they see the mouth of Agasur and mistakes it for the opening of a cave. Krishna and his friends enters the opening of the mouth of Agasur, thinking that it's the opening of a cave. But as soon as Krishna and his friends enter the mouth, Agasur closes his mouth. Soon, because of lack of air, Krishna and his friends begin to suffocate. Krishna realizes that they have been trapped. All his friends fell unconscious inside the stomach of Agasur. Krishna then increases the size of his body, but in response to that, Agasur also increases the size of his body. So finally, Krishna inflates himself like a giant balloon inside the stomach of Agasur, and no air could pass in or out from it anymore. Now this, in return, suffocates the Asur Agasur. Soon, Agasur, in the form of python, runs out of the breath. He tries to throw all the kids out of his stomach, but Krishna's inflated body remains stuck inside his stomach. Soon, the pressure of air builds inside him, and Agasur's eyes pop out of his head, and he immediately dies on the spot. But the air inside the Agasur's body keeps building up, and finally it pops a hole in his head, and from that opening Krishna and his friends jump out of Agasur's body and return back to their village. Krishna finally kills Agasur using his own strategy of suffocating his prey. What does this story teach us in our daily life? The story conveys a message that every one of us faces problems in our lives, but we must grow larger than our problems and use the loopholes in the problem to resolve it, because the answer of every problem lies in itself. In the corporate world, the story of Agasur provides us certain symbols and inspiration. Agasur can be seen as inflation that suffocates and puts pressure on the bottom line of every company. Organizations then must find innovative ways to grow faster than the inflation, and not in just one direction, but find new ways in different directions to increase its bottom line faster than the inflation. And thus, an organization can finally beat inflation by growing faster than Agasur in the form of the inflation. As I always say, mythology is the lighthouse of human civilization. That's all from me today. This is Sandeep Verma from Cobalt Blue Foundation, and you're listening to Beyond Mythologies. For more such videos, do check out our channel, and also check out our last episode about Andhaka, the most powerful story in the books of mythology. Do subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to receive notification for our next episode. Stay home, stay safe, and stay calm.